face of Ruzicko goes down in a heap. Play continuing here. Ruzicko will make his way back to the bench. And now the fight breaks out. It's A.J. Greer against Marcus Foligno. Greer trying to get his team going.
These are two tough guys, too.
And Greer goes full middle linebacker with the takedown.
As you mentioned, Greer's trying to get something going for his side. There's Ruzicka going down. He got an elbow by Maroon.
Pezzetta, quick strike, and that deflected and goes out of play. Pezzetta then hits England, and here we go. Gloves off, and he didn't hesitate. Michael Pezzetta right away with Andreas England. Pezzetta trying to get the rights free. England. Pezzetta the left. England the right. Couple rights for England as Pezzetta tries to free things up and go. Net off the moorings, and these two customers keep going at it. England the left trying to rough up Pezzetta. Pezzetta the right. And that'll do it as Andreas England, 6'4", 200 pounds, going up against Pezzetta, who won't say no to anybody.
Andreas England, no stranger to the rough stuff, 300 games in.
Centers, shot by Bluger, winds up going out of play. I don't know if it hit the goalie or the crossbar or what, but now we got to fight Joshua and Middleton after the whistle. Joshua off balance, oh, and he fell down face first. They'll separate and head to their respective penalty boxes. It was Middleton that Joshua got around to set up that
score. And a shot in tight, save his men. Ooh. Now look out, a collision as England threw the check. Yep. And he's going to go with Mayfield.
Now this is going to be an instigator.
It should be, yep.
Barzell was hit, and I understand it. There's no, but this, Darryl, I think, was one of the cleaner hits I've seen. Of course, now when you have guys willing to drop it, Mayfield and England. But all England did was stand up, and wow, we've seen this before from England. There's not much defense. It's all offense, and now at the end, he's finally getting a couple in there. Mayfield's helmet came off, which is always an advantage for the guy. You save the knuckles that way. But I would expect something extra here, Darryl.
I agree, Jim, because there was another Islander player that was looking to get involved with England.
Horvat.
On the wall. Is Zorko right? Now the gloves are off, and Lozano and Delorier will fight. Been a little while for Nick Delorier. It's time for his fifth fight of the year. Right up near the top. Lozano also very active in that area. He is fighting for the fifth time as well.
Yeah, they didn't like the hit on Tippett, and that's why this fight takes place.
Well, the right hand from Laurier, both swinging with rights. They haven't really connected yet as they have each other at arm's length. Good defensive fight so far. Lozano tries to go uppercut. Now over the top. So there's a right that connected from Laurier. And now he's hammering, trying to reach.
Yeah, just keep swinging and maybe that thing will loosen up.
They get separated to know a little bit about dropping the gloves and fighting.
Each their fifth fight of the year, and they'll head off the ice for the rest of the year.
The thanks by Tippett there, right? Gives a little high five to Nick. Here's the hit. The puck, you know, really wasn't there any longer, and you can see why Delorier probably didn't like that. And, you know, listen, we've seen that time and again this year where teammates stick up for one another. Sealer did it a bunch of times earlier in the year. And you can see Delorier just trying to loosen that right up if he keeps swinging. But
on the draw. And we've got a tilt. Brady Tkachuk going at it with Tucker. Tyler Tucker. Brady Tkachuk. A lot of cheers in here for him. Tucker, some big rights. Tkachuk lands another heavy right. Tkachuk, that woke him up. Throwing some big rights. Tkachuk with the left now, switching, and he takes Tucker down. Brady Tkachuk in the battle, trying to take his team with him as he swings back and has words first bench.
Wow, was that ever a big time scrap? Two big customers not shy to drop the pucks or drop the gloves. And that's the captain sending a message, not only to himself, but to the rest of his group, saying, hey, let's get going here. We're halfway through this game, and we haven't even scratched the surface. Right off the drop of the puck. Kachuk, fearless leader, and both of them get quality shots in. And you see Brady yelling to his bench, saying, let's get going here.
Jabs it on goal. Villar's knocked over. And the puck's under there somewhere. They finally blow it down. And now Gilbert not happy as he gets involved with Tanner Jeannot. Jeannot's a tough customer.
Yeah, he sure is, but
he gets his right going. Lands one over the top, and they go down to the ice. And Dan Vladar is a little slow getting up.
Ooh.
Athletic therapist Kent Kabelka out to see the goaltender. He was pushed over awkwardly in that. Feeds it ahead. Greer bumped as he lifts the puck out, takes a look back to see who hit him. And Sam Carey. More physical stuff, and now Greer and Carrick dropped it. Greer was not happy with that hit.
He was not. He looked right back at Carrick after getting hit.
All this happening with 3 seconds left. And it hasn't been an overly physical game, but to hit the carry through in a game that was pretty much over, and you see the result.
But you still have to play to the end. Yep. I totally get why Greer's not happy, but so he looked at him after the there was a hit before that, and then Greer, yeah, you know, this is always a difficult one.
And Lockwood take it. And we got a fight here. Kolesar Lomberg. Keegan Kolesar took a short right immediately from Lomberg. And the fight is over quickly. Keegan Kolesar trying to wake up his team. And Lomberg caught him with a short jab.
Yeah, Kolesar right off. That can happen. As Lomberg surprised Kolesar on this. Right off the faceoff. There's the punches. See Lomberg able to get inside, hits Kolesar square right off the bat. Right on the jaw. So yeah, some concern here for Kolesar near the goal.
Tell you the story about how he almost ran me over with his car. Yeah. If he had a chance someday.
Here's the gloves, not a surprise.
Someone's gonna get run over here. Middleton and Brendan Dillon.
This is what tight teams do. They answer for each other. And Brendan Dillon won't back down, and good for Middleton. Standing up, saw this coming 5 minutes ago, no doubt about it. Two big men on two really good teams standing up for each other.
Middleton with the early punches, and now Brendan Dillon. A pair of fives.
Minnesota Wild lead the entire National Hockey League in major penalties. This will be their 18th of the year. Winnipeg Jets aren't far behind. They've got guys that will answer the bell, guys like Adam Lowey, Ben Brendan Dillon. Earlier, we showed you the play on Dillon, from Dillon on to Kaprizov, Middleton. You know that they're going to answer. Those are two big men right there, aren't they?
Minnesota
squaring off.
Both 5 minutes each for fighting.
Middleton. Both benches will appreciate that.
Middleton with the old West look with that beauty of a mustache.
Big duster on him.
For second most in history with Patrick Waugh. So potentially a big day and a fight right off the bat. We wondered, would this happen? It's going to be Adam Lowry and Patrick Maroon. A couple of big gentlemen squaring off. Maroon and Lowry, things were chippy yesterday. Kirill Kaprizov is not playing today. He was roughed up a little bit, so this is obviously a carryover from what went on in Winnipeg, and this one's going on a long time. Lowry gets right back up. First grab he's had in this building. Adam Lowry and Pat Maroon start the game.
You got me fired up, Mike Sullivan. I'll see you. Oh, here we go. And right away, 6 seconds
ding, ding, ding.
John Ludwig and Matt Martin, two heavyweights. Rock'em sock'em on New Year's Eve. Martin with a couple quick rights, knocks the helmet off Ludwig, and Pyle drives him to the ice. Oh, the veteran scrapper against the newcomer to the scene right there. Matt Martin gets the decision, but the building loves it.
Missing England with the pass. Benoit advanced and may have got caught. Here's Anderson Dolan shooting, and that ends up deflecting on a play. Benoit, England have dropped the gloves.
So the Predators, now we're going to have the gloves dropped. Ross Johnston is going to square off with Luke Shen. So Luke just talked to Kara Hammer, and then he wants to change the tone. He said they're a half step off. He's trying to change it right now.
Johnston's a big customer, tall order.
Just wrestling around right now. Nobody really able to get free. Shen has a headlock on Johnston. So I'm not sure who initiated that fight, but it was interesting just to hear the thoughts of Shen right before he went back out there. And I think everybody would agree on that bench. They didn't have a great start against the Flames in their last home game. Just trying to get a little tempo.
Frederick, self-pass. Engages with Travis Dermott. And Liam O'Brien has the jackhammer going.
Now, Bruins should get a power play out of this.
Yeah.
You know, Frederick gets in a little back and forth with Dumba, and then all of a sudden, there's Liam O'Brien with his gloves off grabbing Trent Frederick. Total disadvantage for Frederick in that exchange, if you want to call it that. Frederick letting him know it. There's Frederick. I thought it was Dunbar, but it wasn't. It was Dermott. And there comes O'Brien, decided advantage. With
instigator, 2-5-10.
That short side, and Nason was able to squeak it through.
And a penalty coming up here to the Ducks on a big hit.
It was Carrick, and now Lemieux has challenged Carrick.
Is going to find Carrick. Carrick was going to get a minor penalty for boarding, I believe. And the two of them mix it up. Wild swinging overhand rights, and now Lemieux delivers a few in succession as they tumble to the ice.
A big show from Lemieux, no surprise there.
So PNC is alive and kicking as the Canes have regained the lead here in the second.
It's still going to be difficult to, you know, win games. Obviously, you want to have everyone in the lineup, but it doesn't just happen just because everybody's healthy and back.
And now the gloves are off, and Maroon and Delorier will go at it. There was little doubt Delorier would find somebody willing to drop the gloves tonight. The former Wild winger will exchange jabs with Maroon.
Yeah, they both got each other. Good, great grip there by both guys here. And you knew Delorier was a healthy scratch last game. You knew he was going to do something here tonight. And he found a dance partner in Pat Maroon. Both guys playing great defensively. And Delorier just flips over the elbow there and gets a couple shots in. I don't think there was too much damage there. Both guys so experienced, Anthony. Like, these two guys have done this a few times in their career. Finally, Delorier gets his right hand loose there at the very end, gets a couple in on the back of the head of Pat Maroon. Not surprising at all that we, a hockey league game, you can wander out of the net like that and not be that worried if they end up scoring an empty net goal.
Foligno picks up the puck along the wall, got it to Hartman. Middleton fires that one over the top of the net. Faber tried the center.
Here we go.
And here we go as Foligno drops the gloves with Brown. Wondered if this might be a period where Foligno would try to send some kind of a message that enough's enough for the Wild.
And the Brown's a big boy here. Marcus Foligno's got the right hand loose. Brown's a big boy, 6'5", 230 pounds. Marcus Foligno finishes on top there. And
The way he throws the helmet down, I think enough's enough was the message.
Yeah.
The defenseman fires wide blocker side. Oh, he got a scrap right here. This is because of the hit. And that was on Justin Bailey. Bailey struggling on that bench after getting clocked right in front of the bench right there. A little step-up play. Jared Tenorti, no stranger to a fight against Scott Sabourin. And Tenorti making Sabourin pay to start. Sabourin with the right hand in the breastplate of Tenorti. Tenorti landing a right, losing his lid, and Sabourin connects. Tenorti with the right, pushing Sabourin up against the glass.
Oh, look at those seats on the glass, and they got a good look.
Tenorti, his jaw reinforced after it was broken last year. It's full of metal and was made of concrete either way. Tenorti still swinging. Sabourin with his lid still on.
I think they're done. That's a heavyweight battle right there. That's Sabourin coming to the aid of Justin Bailey. And that is Tenorti doing what he does. It was a step-up hit. Looked to me like it was a good hit. Here it is here. Bailey's got his head up right there. He loses control, and it's just a good hit. And then the second part of it, I'm not sure if he got much tangled up on Donato, but that's a good hit right there. But he went off slowly right there, and you can see Tenorti with the hit and then the scrap right after that. That shot right off the bar, too. Don't forget about that with all the aftermath. Tenorti took a couple of lefts right there from Sabourin. Then he regained control of this scrap right here.
That was a big right that he landed on the glass.
Look at the reaction of the fans. Lady on the left there, she doesn't want to see that. The kid loves it. He's clapping.
Up comes Friedel on a rolling disc, and McEwen's going to go here with Pezzetta. Zach McEwen and Michael Pezzetta dropping the gloves at center. This is an old school square off at center. We'll see. Fans are on their feet. We'll see how this unfolds. Early right from McEwen, and he takes some rights, and he goes down. A little finishing right from Pezzetta. McEwen, a tough customer, and Pezzetta trying to get the Habs bench going. It's been an emotional first period. We're not done yet, though. Bring you right back to Canadian Tire Center's hub.
For Arizona, they're credited with six hits total.
Now, we're going to have another fight. This time it's O'Brien and Zadorov. So Liam O'Brien has been busy in this department in the first period. He saw Krause take a pretty healthy run at Zadorov. And Zadorov just got out of the way. I'm not sure if that was in retaliation for something else, but Zadorov's got the right hand loose on O'Brien.
A power play of the night. So after Tampa went 3-for-3 with the extra man last night, Minnesota's penalty killers come through in their first shorthanded situation. Now we got another fight as Foligno drops the gloves at center ice. Badjovic with a couple of left jabs into the chin of Foligno.
Both got themselves tied up pretty good. You really don't have a free hand. All you do is try short jabs like Gadget just tried there.
Now, it's been a lengthy bout between these two. Second fight of the first period. And the linesman will finally step in and break it up. So just after Foligno comes out of the penalty box.
There we go.
And here we go off the draw. Lomberg against McBain. Gadjevich was looking to see if he would go with O'Brien. Ryan Lomberg doesn't take many faceoffs. And really didn't take that one.
Well, there's some haymakers being thrown right there.
Now keep in mind, that's not Zucker. So when Lomberg went over to Zucker, they were chatting in the pregame. Others came over. So there's the first fight of the night, and we'll see if it's the only one at the 5-second mark.
Number 22, number 94, Arizona, Florida. Both guys for 5 each fighting.
Yeah, you don't see putting the mustard on it.
You don't see it very often, but this is a little carryover from the first meeting, as we just showed you. And the Panthers, they're a team that sticks together. And there you see, as soon as they drop the puck.
All right, so now Kevin Stenlund comes on to take the actual faceoff, perhaps. It's Lawson Crouse. I think we're going to go again.
Here we go.
And here's O'Brien and Gadjevich now squaring up at center ice. So you saw the chatter, the pregame warm-ups, two fights in the first 7 seconds. These are two guys that know what they're doing, and they're sizing each other up. Both grab on.
O'Brien, he leads the NHL in penalty minutes. And now we look at Gadjevich. He's not very happy that the linesman jumped in.
So that's two.